So now come to lecture number 2. Next sense of hearing that is nose. Okay. So we'll see about next is nose. So we know that we smell with the help of our nose. We breathe also with the help of our nose. Now the nose has two openings called nostril. First opening, second opening, and these are known as nostrils. First thing, we smell with our nose. This is first. Second is that the nose has two openings called nostril. Okay, first opening and second opening. Now each nostril leads to a nasal cavity covered with a sticky substance called mucus. Yes. Now each nostrils leads to a nasal cavity. Okay, in each nostril there is a nasal cavity is there, and cavity with a sticky substance. In your nose there is some sticky substance are there, that is called mucus. Okay. So third point is, each nostril leads to a nasal cavity covered with a sticky substance called mucus. Is everyone understood that sticky substance in our nose, that is called mucus? A specialized cells lining the nasal cavity are sensitive to smell and send message to the brain through nerves on detecting the smell. Okay. Now whatever the specialized cells lining through in our nose, now whatever we smell, now after that this nasal whatever cells are there, specialized cell, these sends message to the brains, and after that brains easily detects that what is the smell of this, any food, anything, it can detect by our brain. How? Then whatever we smell, some specialized cells are there, in our nose. That specialized cell sends message to the brain, and after that, that brain is able to detect the smell of that things. If it is food, if it is rotten, anything, it can be easily detected by our brain, but it is done by our specialized cells which is present in our nostrils, nose. Okay, so now we'll move to next one, that is tongue. So everyone knows that the tongue is responsible for detecting taste. With the help of our tongue, we can taste that this food is bitter, sweets, anything we can taste, salty. So the tongue is responsible for detecting the taste. Everyone knows the tongue is responsible for detecting the taste, such as sweet, salty, sour, and bitter. Okay, if you will eat any sour things, you will easily, if you eat mango, then you will easily recognize that this is sour. It is, if that mango is ripe, we can easily recognize this sweet. So this tongue is very important for us. It is also help us to chew food and to speak. Yes, tongue is also, see what, when I am speaking, my tongue flips up and down. So this tongue also helps to chew the food. Now when you will eat, not teeth will work, your tongue will also work on that time. It helps to chew food and speak. The surface of the tongue is covered with tiny bumps called called the taste buds. Okay, this surface of tongue is covered with the tiny bumps that is called taste buds. With the help of this, we can easily we recognize that what is the taste of that food. So the surface of the tongue is covered with tiny bumps called taste buds. The taste buds have nerves that connect to the brain. The taste bud identify a different taste and send the signal to the brain. Now, this taste bud only it is connected to the brain, and whatever we taste, it is detected by the our taste buds, and after that taste bud sends message to the brain, and we easily recognize that what any food tastes. Okay, so the taste buds identify different tastes and send signal to the brain. Okay, why? Because this taste buds is connected to the our brain. Now we will move to last topic, that is skin. So now come the last one, skin. So the skin is the largest sense organs. Why? Because that skin is covered, it covers all the parts of your body, and it will be responsible for the sense of touch. Here, if somebody touches your skin, then you can feel. Okay, so it is responsible for the sense of touch. Our skin, the first thing, it is the largest sense organs. Because see, we have only two eyes, two ears, one nose, one tongue, but skin covers all part of the body. That's why it is the largest sense organ, and it is responsible for the sense of touch. Okay, somebody touch your hand, then you can easily feel that yes, somebody touch your cheek, somebody touch your anything, you can easily recognize that somebody has touched my this part. Now this sense of touch help us to feel pain. Yes, if I heat, then this sense of touch only like yes, I cold, hot. So this sense of touch helps us to feel pain, heat, cold, and etc. Yeah, if you will keep eyes on your hand, then what will you will feel cold? If somebody will keep you hot, cold, then you will feel. Sorry, if somebody will keep eyes you, then you will feel cold. If somebody will keep you hot, cold, then you will feel hot. Okay, if somebody will beat you, hit you, any streak, and whatever, you feel any pain. And this all due to the skin, because it is responsible for only the sense of touch. It also helps in regulating body temperature and protecting the body from germs. Okay, so it is also responsible. It also helps in regulating body temperature and protecting from germ. Yes, imagine if you do not have skin, now whatever germs will be there, that will directly enter into your body, and you will fall ill. That's why the skin is very important. The skin consists of three layers: epidermis, dermis, and hypodermis. It consists of three layers. Epidermis, dermis, and hyperdermis. This chapter 7 is over. Whatever question answer video to the kind of one is there, I will upload. In next classes, I will go for chapter 8. So for now, goodbye to all of you.